They say you have to lose yourself to find yourself, but I never thought I was lost. As a kid, I knew I was destined for greatness. I would dream about becoming a Los Angeles Dodger. There's just some sort of magic when your cleats hit the dirt. It kept me grounded. The smell of the grass, the crack of the bat. Knowing you had a team of people that wanted the same thing. It just made you feel like you were part of something bigger than yourself. The fact is, I've always had big dreams. My entire childhood, I felt I was destined for baseball. It wasn't until my teens that I thought I could be anything different. People ask me, what changed? The truth is, there was a lot of tension between my dad and I. After my parents divorced, it was like the only thing we had in common. It was like my dad didn't see me no more. All he saw was the game. And that just became too painful. I felt like I was living out his dreams instead of mine. And I wasn't even sure what my dreams were anymore. You know, people always tell you could be anything. And that's the truth. But they can't tell you who to become or how hard the journey will be to get there. That will always fall on us to figure out. Because if we always become who everyone else thinks we should be, we will never be true to ourselves. It took me a while to find myself. In the midst of my parents divorcing, I walked away from the greatest love and the only sport I knew, and I found music. The music was always there. I've had family play for some of the greats, Motley Crue and Ozzy Osbourne. Some of my clearest memories of my father was sitting in his garage, watching him drink and tapping the keys on his organ. Who would have thought I'd walk the same path? I didn't even have my dad anymore. He had disappeared. But I found him at the bottom of every bottle I drank, every line I snorted, and every pill I popped. He was always there in my own reflection. These things mask the pain, but the poetry and music held it. The music became my therapy, but never did I think I would be the one to share it with the world. That's the funny thing about purpose. It's not something that can be taught. It's just in your blood. Me and my sister were walking the dogs one day, and I shared this vision I had with her. I plan to put out 2 projects a year for the next few years just to give people something to vibe to. For an unsigned small city kid, this is an impossible dream. The amount of money, time, and consistent effort it takes to put out meaningful, high-quality work is substantial. Most artists we hear on the radio don't even do that. So I tatted for the music. I designed clothes for the music. I put blood, sweat, and tears into the music. Nobody paved my way. I made a way. And here we are 5 years later, unsigned, singles on the radio, larger fan base than some of the artists we know and love, and a movement that is recognized worldwide. You see, they said I could do anything, and that was the truth.
Hi, baby.
Something's not right.
What do you mean?
I just can't breathe. I just can't breathe. I can't focus. I just feel like something's wrong with me.
This was the start of my fall. I went from never being home to not being able to leave the house. I couldn't even move sometimes. I was laid out on the same couch for hours, even days. Trembling, uncontrollable shakes, weakness, difficulty breathing. I thought I was gonna die. I wasn't sure if I was going through withdrawals, facing a medical condition, having a nervous breakdown. I couldn't even explain what I was going through physically and mentally. All I could do was cry. It stripped me of everything. I couldn't handle the pressure of seeing people, so I would call my boy Omar several times a day and just cry on the phone with him. He was my anchor in a way because he had gone through something like this before. He told me nobody would understand me unless they've been through it themselves. The loneliness that came from that realization was darker and deeper than I can explain. Omar would tell me, "T, this is just a season. This will make you a better person." I didn't understand that. Like, how could this much pain, fear, panic, and uncertainty make me a better person? I thought he was lying to me. I thought I would be this way for the rest of my life, and who would want to live without any of the things they loved? I couldn't tattoo, I couldn't perform, I couldn't write music, I couldn't exercise, I couldn't even breathe. I had lost myself completely. When you're in this dark of a place, when you're forced into solitude, you're forced to grapple with yourself. Where did I go wrong? What did I do to deserve this? That's a victim mentality. What did I do to cause this? Now that's the real question. There's a lot of pressure in this game. After all these years of being independent, I was starting to conform to what the industry and culture really thinks a rapper is, trying to balance running three companies while maintaining an image that wasn't fully myself. Going out every night, getting wasted, snorting lines, popping pills. We don't realize how fragile our bodies are. I pushed and pushed and pushed my body to the brink until it finally gave up. But the truth is, there's nothing else that would have caught my attention. You know, sometimes we're forced to face a crossroads. We are forced to choose between who we are and who we are supposed to become. That crossroads can be rough and rocky, and that's what this was. It was a wake-up call like, "Yo, Tone, I'm gonna let you go through this so you don't lose everything you've worked for. Who are you going to become? You know, I think, what if this didn't happen to me? What if I gained the success I've been chasing without coming to these understandings, without preparing for the pressures and being grounded? I would have thrown everything away." We tend to think success looks like money, fame, people knowing your name. What I've realized is that if your character isn't refined and you aren't grounded in yourself, that success will be met with failure. Nobody else could fix this for me. No person, no thing, no meds. I mean, the easiest thing for me to do would have been to pop some pills and forget what I was going through. That's what we do culturally, we numb ourselves. The only problem with that is those issues remain when the pills wear off. I remember looking at a bottle of Xanax and thinking to myself, I have more homies than I can count that ruined their lives over a substance like this, that went from opiate use to heroin use to overdose. The pills weren't the answer. I needed to confront this myself. Everybody's beliefs are different. But for me, the answer was finding peace, allowing myself to really feel what I was going through. You can't make it to the other side without allowing yourself to go through it. So I prayed. I rooted myself in community. I surrounded myself with people who believed, who loved, who challenged, who pushed me. And that was ultimately my family. I knew there was something greater on the other side, but I knew it would take all of me to get there. Thankfully, giving up has never really come that easy. I had to come back to myself. When the rap's gone, when the money's gone, when the attention is gone, and I'm laying awake in my bed at night, there are only a few things that truly matter. My family, my faith, and my story. What story am I writing? Who am I writing it for? I don't want to be remembered as someone who lost his way. I want to be remembered as a man who never gave up, who confronted himself, even the darkest parts of himself, and who came out on the other side a better human being. We have that choice, you and me. We are the same. We have purpose. Whether we tap into that purpose is up to each of us. You can live an authentic life. You can use your influence and power for good. You can choose to become your best self every day. No Xanax Needed is not only a stance I took medically and physically during one of the hardest times of my life. It's a philosophy I've adopted, a way of life. Knowing the easy way is not always the best way. This project wasn't masterminded or synthetically created. It's real. And it's raw. It's a journey I wanted to share with you about my greatest fall in hopes I will pull you out of yours. If at the end of the day only one life is changed with this project, I mean, even if it's only my life that's changed, I know it was worth it. Because it's not how many times you fall, but how many times you're willing to stand back up. This is the heart of the movement. Top of the food chain to my brain hangs. Hi-Tone. This is shit you gon' ride to, gon' cry to. All alone in your whip, nobody gon' see you. But fuck them if they see you. This is your life, homie. Let it out, young homie. Let it out. Ooh, I've been feeling down. I ain't been making sounds. I ain't been at the house making dance on the couch. This is all.